there, Michelle Lang. I'm an occupational therapist in the Denver, Colorado area, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about mini proportional joysticks. Now, power wheelchair drivers, for the most part, are going to use a standard joystick. A standard joystick requires about 250 grams of force and about 28 millimeters of travel distance. Now, I'm an OT, I'm not a mathematician, and that doesn't really mean that much to me. But to give you some context, mini proportional joysticks, which are a smaller version of a standard joystick, also require a fraction of the force and travel that a standard joystick requires. So for example, a mini proportional may require 10 or 50 grams of force as opposed to 250, and may require as little as 3 millimeters of travel as opposed to that 28 millimeter travel. So why is this important? Well, for someone who has muscle weakness, this can be very helpful and allow someone the benefits of joystick use, proportional directional control, proportional speed control, but a much smaller package. Now, in our last video, we talked about compact joysticks. This provides a smaller package for someone who maybe doesn't need the bulk of a standard joystick, but it requires the same amount of force and travel. Mini proportionals require less. So let's talk about these a little bit. Here's an example of a cute little mini proportional joystick. So again, much, much smaller than a standard joystick, even smaller than a compact joystick, and requires much less force and travel to get where you need to go. These are so sensitive that many of them tend to be rather fragile, so we need to be aware of this. And these do not make good attendant controls, because if I come along as a caregiver and try to grab this and drive someone around, there's a good chance I'm going to break it. So these mini proportionals tend to fall into two main categories. Many of these require approximately 50 grams of force, and those tend to work well at the chin. We then have minis that require as little as 10 grams of force. This one actually requires about 8 grams of force, and these work well at a finger or a thumb. Why? Well, our joysticks that require more like 50 grams of force work better at the chin because we have more leverage with our head, and sometimes controlling such a very sensitive mini joystick at the chin can be challenging, especially over rough terrain. So we use a little more robust joystick, mini proportional, still about 50 grams. Of course, each individual is unique. Now, one challenge of using a joystick at the chin is repetitive stress injuries. This is about the only driving method where our client is at risk of repetitive stress injuries, and these can occur either at the jaw or at the cervical area. So one way we reduce that risk is to reduce the force. We still have repetitive movements, but we have less resistance, and that can reduce the risk for chin joystick drivers. So let's look at a few examples. This joystick here, this mini proportional, is from Stealth Products, and it is called their PMP, or Precision Mini Proportional. Some unique things about this is that it has this gasket here. It's completely sealed, and that helps avoid anything getting in there like moisture, dirt, secretions that could booger this up and perhaps result in this breaking. So if that's an issue for a client, you might want to look for one of these that is completely sealed. This comes in a version that plugs into a standard 9-pin connection on a power chair. There's also a version that plugs into the iDrive system that Stealth offers, and that provides for some additional programming. Another option is this guy here. This is the multi mini proportional joystick from Movis. This requires about 50 grams of force. Oh, I forgot to say, PMP here requires about 43 grams of force, and again, much reduced travel. Just a skosh more is the multi, about 50 grams of force. And you can see on this joystick are two little ports here. One is for power, that's the red one, and one is for yellow, that's for a mode switch. You can plug in any switch you want there. So I can take something like this AbleNet Jelly Bean switch, and I can grab the switch jack on it and just reach over and plug it right in. And now when I activate this switch, I can turn the chair on and off, for example. Now, let's say I have this mounted up by someone's chin. I may not want all these wires hanging out and stuff. So along this cable from this mini proportional joystick is this box. And on this box, I have the same red and yellow switch jacks for power and for mode. I also have this little mini USB port, and that is for programming. Movis, like iDrive, has its own programming software, and I can program some additional features. And then finally, another example I have here is this little guy that I showed initially. And this is the micro joystick from Movis. And it only requires 8.5 grams of force and only 3.3 millimeters of travel, as opposed to a standard joystick, which is about 28. So much, much smaller. Now, this is so little, there's no room here for those switch ports. So again, in line with the cable, we have this, and it has those switch ports as well as a USB programming port on it as well. Now, all these need to be mounted. Perhaps we'll do a video at a future time about mounting these, but whether we're placing this by someone's finger or by chin, we need to make sure it's well mounted. We need to make sure the client is well positioned. So again, if you would like more information on mini proportional joysticks, because there's a lot of them, go to my website under resources and you can see a comparison chart of these joysticks. My website's listed in the description under this video. And thanks very much for your time today. Bye-bye.